Welcome to the International Space Station Flight Control Room. This is Mission Control Houston, Thursday, August 23rd. As a team of flight controllers watching over Expedition 32 crew's shoulders throughout its workday aboard the International Space Station, the team today is being led by Flight Director Tomas Gonzalez Torres. He's been overseeing the team since early Thursday morning, and the team will be on console until mid to late afternoon, handing over to the oncoming shift. He's joined on console by Robert Handley, who is handling the communications duties between the Houston flight control team and the crew aboard the International Space Station. That space station is currently orbiting in a new record altitude for the International Space Station. The current average altitude of the complex is now about 259 statute miles, about 416 kilometers. That is a new altitude, or at least average altitude, record for the station following Wednesday's two-part reboost maneuver that was conducted by the European automated transfer vehicle that's docked to the aft end of the Russian segment of the station. The ATV-3, known as the Eduardo Amaldi, performed that reboost maneuver in two parts Wednesday morning, and the result of that, of course, is the current orbital average altitude of about 259 statute miles. The station currently is on the dark side of the Earth, approaching the Philippines from the northwest, tracking southeasterly, and will fly across portions of Australia before heading across central New Zealand, then out into an orbital sunrise high above the South Pacific. The crew on board Expedition 32, three of the crew members are enjoying their 101st day in space, 99 of those aboard the International Space Station, those three being the commander of Expedition 32, Gennady Padalka from Russia. He's joined by Sergei Revin from Russia also, and Joe Acaba, U.S. astronaut. Those three launched to the station back in mid-May and will be aboard the complex, planned to head home on Sunday, September 16th. The other three crew members, the newest three crew members on the long-duration mission aboard the station, are Russian Yuri Malenchenko and U.S. astronauts Sonny Williams and the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Akihiko Hoshide. Those three arrived at the station back in mid-July. They are enjoying their 40th day in space, 38 of those now aboard the International Space Station. It's quite a busy day for the crew aboard the complex, with some human exploration experiment work being conducted by the Russian crew members on board, while the three U.S. operating system astronauts, Joe Acaba, Sonny Williams, and Aki Hoshide, spent a good deal of their morning and now wrapping up activities in the U.S. airlock quest associated with the checkout of their extravehicular mobility units. They're doing an on-orbit fit check verification, and they've been doing that for quite a bit of the morning with a good bit of interaction with the flight control team here on the ground, the EVA team that is preparing for Sonny Williams and Aki Hoshide's spacewalk planned for next week on August 30th, a spacewalk that will include the two astronauts replacing a faulty power relay unit on the station's truss, which is known as a main bus switching unit. Additionally, some additional work by the seventh crew member, if you will, on board. Robonaut 2 is underway aboard the station as well, back in the U.S. laboratory Destiny. Robonaut 2 has been activated to assist in learning how it can help crew members by manipulating switches and push buttons on task panels that are strategically mounted in front of Robonaut 2. That robot is being operated by a team of engineers above us here in the flight control room up on the fifth floor of the Mission Control Center. The crew's interacting a little bit with Robonaut 2 in terms of activating all of its systems, and then letting the team on the ground conduct all of the activities associated with the task panel remotely. So busy for all six crew members and Robonaut aboard the International Space Station as the team works through supporting all of the crew's activities on board throughout the day.